Hello and welcome back to my channel Get Coded, and today we are going to start with our class 2 on HTML. So before we move forward with our class 2, let me just brief you all up with the previous class. So in previous class I had explained you all about what is HTML and which all editors we are going to use, okay? Which all editors are available to use for HTML. So there is Notepad, Notepad++, and Visual Studio Code, and many others may be there. Okay, we also created our first web page. So in today's class, we are just going to learn about what is a tag, what is an attribute. Okay, so in tags and attributes, I am going to teach you all about the heading tag and the image tag. Okay, so these two tags will complete our tags and attributes. So let me just brief you all about a tag. Tag is something which is enclosed within this angular braces. Okay, and a element is something which is everything that is from the start tag to the end tag. So if I tell you that it is a paragraph element, that means you need to have a start tag and an end tag. Okay, so that's about the tags. So there are two type of tags available, that is the container tag and a standalone tag. For the container tag, you need to have a starting tag, okay, and you need to have a ending tag. This is an example of a paragraph element. Okay, so there is a starting tag and there is an ending tag. Now comes the second type of tag, that is the standalone tag. So here there is only one, that is only the starting tag is available. There is no ending tag. So for the container tag, we are going to learn about the heading tag, and for the standalone tag, we are going to learn about the image tag. So let me just quickly write down the skeleton of our program. Okay, and in title, we are doing our class 2. Okay, so in body, so basically we are going to start with the container tags. So in the container tag, we are doing the heading tag. So there are 6 headings available. You can see H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6. So these headings I will show you all with an example. Okay. So inside these tags, there would be a content. Okay. So let's say most important or the largest tag. Okay, so these are the tags available for the heading tag. So let's just check our program. You can see class 2 is there. So you can see the largest tag has come, then the second largest, then the third one, then the fourth one, the fifth one, and the smallest tag. That means this one is the H1 tag. Okay, this is the H2 tag. You can see the text written in them. The H1 encloses the largest tag, then the second largest, third one, fourth one. You can see like that, and the smallest tag is for the H6 tag. Okay, so these are the heading tags that are available. And here comes our, I'll just comment this. And we'll just move ahead with our next type of tag, that is the standalone tag. And for standalone tag, we are doing an example of image tag. So it has only the starting point, there is no ending point for this. For an image tag, we need to have some image, okay? So for it, we need one attribute called as src attribute, which gives the source of the image. Since there is no image which is available here, we'll just download one. So you can see this is the moon image. If you don't know how to save the image, just right click on it and save image as, and just give it a name. Let's say I am giving it a name as a moon. Make sure to save your image in the same HTML folder where you are saving your HTML file. Okay, once saved, you can just give your source as the name which was given. So moon.jpg is our image. Why.jpg? Because this image has a type of JPG. Okay, so when you save this and when you refresh your page, you can see your image has appeared, but it is too wide and too long for this web page. You can just zoom out to see full image, or you can just edit it like how I will show you. Okay, so you can see, if you want to see like this on 100%, okay, let me just reset it to 100%. We will come to the image tag and we will add two attributes called as the width attribute and the height attribute. Okay, so in width attribute, just give some width, let's say 600 pixels. Okay, this is basically in pixels, 600 by 600 pixels. So when I do it and when I refresh it now, you can see the image has appeared. Now it is not too wide or too long. So you can see this is at my 100%, you can see this image. So if you all know that sometimes the image fails to load, okay, let me just save this file as neon.jpg, and I have no image called as neon.jpg. And now when I refresh this page, you can see this small icon here. Let me zoom in. You can see the small item here which has reserved the 600 pixels by 600 pixel space. So this is what sometimes appears. So I want the users to know what this image is about if my image fails to load. So I will say this is an moon image. Okay, I have saved it, and now when I refresh my page and zoom in, you can see the moon image along with this small icon has come. So whenever my page fails to display an image, it will show moon image. Okay, whenever this image fails to load. Okay, so if I write here moon back, my moon image alternative text will vanish. So now if I refresh, you can see the moon back here with no text. So that's it for my this lecture. You can remove this comment here. So make sure to like, share and subscribe to my channel, and also press that bell icon so you don't miss any updates regarding my videos. I post every Monday and on Wednesday, so make sure you subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching.